is Bruno Loyer with Siemens PLM Software. Today, I will show you the design exploration features that are available in the LMS Imagine Lab AmSim environment. The design exploration module allows you to do three kinds of things. Firstly, you can define design of experiments, also known as DOEs. DOEs are very useful to create response surfaces that could replace your model. DOEs can also be used to get the respective influences of your parameters on your design. Secondly, you can do optimizations with two different algorithms. We have the genetic algorithm, that is for the global search of a large design space. We also have a local gradient-based algorithm called NLPQL. And lastly, through the Monte Carlo analysis, you can assess the robustness of your design with respect to uncertainties related to the design variables themselves or to the operating conditions of your system. In this first video, I will show an example of optimization applied to the use case of an injector model. An injector system is a complex system because it needs to satisfy precise requirements in terms of injected quantity. But also, it is subjected to tight manufacturing tolerances. If we simulate this first model, here we can see that we have the complete injected volume here. Currently, its value is slightly below 40 cubic millimeters, and in this example, we'll try to optimize it such that it reaches the value of 50 cubic millimeters. And for this purpose, we will optimize some geometrical parameters. So here I will just hold this curve, that is the previous curve before optimization, and now I will define my optimization study. So we assume that our configuration has already been set. So when opening this window, we see that we have our input parameters where we can find our geometrical parameters, diameter of the hole, diameter of the puppet, also the puppet half angle parameter. Here we have a second tab called simple output parameters. Those are the responses of your model. And both the input and the outputs can be used for defining what we call compound output parameters that can be the objective functions that you are trying to minimize, as well as some auxiliary functions that could serve for defining feasibility constraints. So in this example, we have set an objective function to be the absolute difference between the target value of 50 cubic millimeters and the current injected quantity. And here we have specified a difference between the puppet diameter and the hole diameter that needs to be above a certain value. Once this is done, we can start the design exploration tool. So here we can see that we have three possibilities for studies. We can either have DOE, optimization, or Monte Carlo. In this first video, we are dealing with optimization. So here, if I edit this study, we have selected NLPQL algorithm. We can change the relative gradient step. We can also adapt the final desired accuracy, knowing that lower value needs to longer optimization times. And here, we can find the inputs, the design variables that we had previously selected, with their default values, lower and upper bounds. Here, on the second tab, we can see the objective functions. So here, when we tick it, we mean that we want to minimize the difference with the target value that we had specified. Here we see that we have specified a lower bound for this difference between those two diameters. So now we can start the optimization as such, and the NLPQL algorithm will compute the best solution within several iterations. By the way, note that the gradient calculation takes benefits from the parallelization because it is parallelized as all other design exploration features, such as the genetic algorithm, for which the population is spread out on the many cores that you might have at disposal, either locally or remotely. And also, of course, the Monte Carlo studies that we will see in the second video take benefits from the multi-core capabilities of your machines. Now that the optimization is complete, we can see that we have reached a solution that satisfies the constraint that we had previously defined. And we can see the value of the objective here. And we have a specialized plot here that, for instance, we can plot the history plot of our objective function here. And when selecting a logarithmic scale, we can see how far the value of the difference, the absolute difference with our target value for injected volume has been reached here. Another nice feature of the optimization is that you can apply these values to your system through the apply best results function here, and we will see what happens. Now I restart simulating my model, and we will see now that the results are as expected. The value of 50 cubic millimeters is reached. So this concludes our first video. If you're interested in seeing an example of Monte Carlo analysis, then please take a look at our second video.